Skinias Beach at Marathon. Here, in 490 BC, 70,000 Persians disembarked and made their way to Attica. Their goal was the destruction of Athens. Passing through Evia, they had already decimated Eritrea within 6 days. The Athenians, realizing the critical condition of the situation, decided to confront the invaders at Marathon and not at the city. At the same time, Athens asked Sparta for help and sent their day sprinter, Pheidippides. Flyer Pheidippides outdid himself and arrived at Sparta the following day. Herodotus reports the fact as history, but 20th century historians have their doubts. The distance covered by Pheidippides over mountainous and rough terrain covered 246 kilometers in less than 2 days and seems impossible to us now. But a group of British Hellenists dared to try it. In 1982, they attempted the same route as Pheidippides, and they achieved it. John Fondon, John Salton, and John McCarthy, all Royal Air Force officers, finished at Leonidas' statue at Sparta within 39 hours. So it seems Herodotus was right. The legend was revived, and in an atmosphere of general excitement, the Spartathlon was born, a very long-distance foot race that follows the steps of Pheidippides. The next year, 46 athletes from 11 different countries participated. The first winner was the Greek athlete, Yannis Koros, from Arcadia. Koros will go on to be distinguished as a phenomenal athlete. He participates 4 times at Spartathlon and will win at all 4 by setting the 4 best times until now in the history of the race. The association's meeting, the day before the race, at the London Hotel. Briefing in 3 languages.
We will do the briefing today just to clarify something in English. We won't do it in Greek. We won't do it in any other languages, Japanese, because of the high number of Japanese people. And any other runners from any other foreign country that does not understand anything, after the briefing, please come to me and we will explain for you. Tomorrow morning, all the buses depart from all the hotels at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. So your items,
questions, clarifications, explanations. Now everything is ready for the Spartathlon 2009 to begin. Dawn, Friday, 25th of September. The city is beginning to wake up. In front of the Acropolis, athletes, running mates, relatives and friends are preparing. athletes from 33 countries have shown up at the starting point, which is a new record. Present is the Pole, Peter Corillo, who once again, in keeping with his tradition, this year came from his country by foot. Also by foot came his countryman, Darius Strykalski. For Strykalski, the challenge is doubled, since he is a paraplegic athlete with special needs. But the Pole will turn his special needs into unique and astonishing abilities in order to reach the finishing line. 7 o'clock in the morning, and the race begins. Elefsina. The modern road follows the tracks of the ancient one. The athletes enter the city, passing the ancient bridge. This is where the processions of the pilgrims passed during the Eleusinian mysteries. Here, the goddess Demetra, patron of agriculture and nature, was worshipped. Values that our modern culture no longer respects, as it did during the time of Elefsina. Elefsina preserved its importance as a great industrial and economic centre. Ancient Elefsina coexists with the new. While the race goes through settlements and factories, The runners will also catch a glimpse of the blue sea from time to time. Coordinated steps. The blind Japanese athlete Yoshi Hosina and his guide are heading towards Sparta. The human will overcome even the greatest difficulties. At the checkpoints, there is overcrowding. Runners move quickly. There are short dialogues and encouraging applause. The tables are laden with food and drinks. It has been calculated that each athlete needs more than 9 litres of fluids during the race. So, throughout the course of the race, the association offers more than 6 tons of water, isotonic drinks, and refreshments. The road to Corinth passes through the Skironian Road, the modern Kakia Skala. These imposing rocks are drenched in the Greek mythology of Skiron and Procrustes, legendary bandits that terrorized travelers until the Athenian hero Theseus defeated them and freed the area. Midday, at the main checkpoint at Isthmus, the entranceway of the Peloponnese. The checkpoint is located next to the remains of the ancient wall of Exarmyli. Exarmyli was an ancient fortification wall of about 10 kilometres that was built in order to protect the Peloponnese from enemy invasions. One after the other, the runners arrive at the checkpoint. Here is the first major checkpoint station, where the athletes can have immediate help from volunteers, grab a quick snack, and get a relaxing massage. There are four teams of physiotherapists, five in each team. The teams are separated according to the race needs, and during the race are placed at nine different points of control along the way. Their role is of equal importance with the doctors, because we take on the muscular relaxation and the initial treatment of cramps and muscular injuries of the athletes in order to enable them as much as we can to continue the race. Here we have a basic medical team that treats all the incidents. The unit consists of six doctors who will take it in turns to work at the next checkpoints. Until now, the race has gone well. We have no incident or accident or any other problem, and we believe that we are ready to face whatever comes up, of course, with the help of Corinth's hospital.
Πάντα βέβαια και με τη βοήθεια του νοσοκομείου Κορίνθου να το αντιμετωπίσουμε.
Usually, the athletes stop here for a little longer. After 80 kilometers of the race, they continue to have high spirits. The difficulties will come later. At the Isthmus checkpoint, there is also the table with the race's online transmission on the internet. Spartathlon's progress is transmitted live, and it is accessible everywhere.
Is meat or not? No meat? I did it, okay.
What moves a lot of us about the Spartathlon, since it was established 27 years ago, is the fact that it is the only very long-distance foot race that has historical background, based on a real historical event. It also brings in athletes from many countries, who are not only interested in the fight to reach the finishing line, but also acknowledge the past that makes this very long-distance foot race.
Αλλά και τη ματιά προς το παρελθόν το οποίο σηματοδοτεί αυτό τον υπερμαραθώνιο.
Ένας είναι ο δεντρινός. Άλλο τρία κοκακόλα.
A little further on stands ancient Corinth. The athletes pass through the centre of the modern settlement. Ancient Corinth was one of the most important Greek centres. Standing at the entrance of the Peloponnese, it had ports in two bays, and so was an important commercial, artistic, but also athletic centre, where the Isthmia took place. One of the four great Pan-Hellenic Games. Corinth's position continued to be significant during the Middle Ages too, as the powerful castle of Acrocorinth states. The walls of this historical city embody life from ancient times until the 19th century. Passing through Corinthia, the race trail passes through gardens, olive plantations, vineyards, and scenic villages. Has an ancient tradition in viniculture. The grapes' bunches hang teasingly on the arbors. This is a fruit that the athletes will not taste today, since it can cause them stomach disorders that could knock them out of the race. The Snake's Villa at Corinthia. Every 3 or 4 kilometres, there are checkpoints that are staffed by volunteers, members and friends of the association, members of the Karakopian University, volunteers from the Athens Olympic Games, social organisations volunteers, people from the local administration, but also many civilians who selflessly offer their services. I think that every Spartathlon is touching, considering that all those people come literally from all over the world to run this historical trail. For something so small and insignificant to other people, perhaps, only for an olive branch and a little water from the river. I think that this is a very positive motivation for all of us. I have participated at Spartathlon for 8 years, and I'm very excited by the fact that athletes from all over the world come here, and we offer whatever we can and try to help them and show them how hospitable Greece is and how much we appreciate their effort. For me, Spartathlon is a way to volunteer to the athletes that come from all over the world here to run this difficult race, honoring Greece and the ancient Greek culture. Darkness is falling. During ancient times, the Nemean Games were conducted here in honour of Zeus and was one of the four Panhellenic Games. Nemea's temple stands next to the modern settlement. Today, the stadium, the Zeus's sanctum and remains of several buildings are preserved. As night falls, the runners stop in order to regain their energy. The fatigue is obvious. Their natural reserves are exhausted. All they have now are their psychological reserves, on which they will depend. Malandreni, an oasis of life at night. The residents are out on the streets and welcome the runners. Here, in this village, the Spartathlon is considered an institution. So we believe we should all participate. It is a historical moment for our village, athletics in general, and for the tradition of Greece, and we believe that the people should come and encourage it. Lyrkia, another checkpoint station. The village stays up to watch the race. Lights, movement, drinks. The delicious souvlakia from the nearby grill houses are yet another forbidden delicacy for the athletes. The diet of the race's athletes proposes a difficult equation of foods, liquids, and quantities. The wrong proportions could cause major problems for the athletes, and the race would end in disaster. The trail in the dark, desolate landscape, lonely kilometres. The checkpoints are the only places with life around, manned by willing volunteers. The athletes show up in the darkness. A kind word and a few seconds of relaxation.
Special.
The athlete vanishes in the darkness. There will be a while until the next one will show up. The distances between them are long.
203.
Crossing the wilderness with a flashlight. From here, the road leads to Artemisio, or to the mountain, as it is known among the athletes. They will climb up the 1,200 metres from the ancient path, the climax, as Pausanias calls it. From here, in cold conditions, they will start to descend to Arcadia. It is the toughest part of the trail. As dawn approaches on Saturday, the weather's getting worse. The leading runner, Japanese Ryotsi Sakia, enters a very wet Sparta. It is Sakia's second victory at Spartathlon. He ran an amazing course, finishing the race in 23 hours, 48 minutes and 24 seconds. About 45 minutes later, the Danish Lars Christoffersen finishes. third is Jan Berger from Norway. What is amazing about the Spartathlon is that half of the athletes have participated many times. It is like a family that has a date each year in September to celebrate together. The big champion here is the Finnish, Seppo Tapo Lenonen, who has participated every year for 25 years and has finished 15 times. The Spartathlon race is an extremely mystical race for me. I cannot explain exactly what happens, but each year I must come here because I feel as if I have the mission to carry out something. It is extremely important for me. It is like a second wedding. The race is internationally very important, and each year, Leonidas' statue at Sparta awaits all the runners.
Tämä on ehdottomasti maailman rankin, ja varmasti juoksijoiden ihannoima patsas odottaa aina Spartassa Leonidaksen patsas.
Saturday morning at Tegia. At the side of the road stands the canteen truck that carries supplies to the checkpoints throughout the course. The race continues in the rain. Athletes arrive, others leave. Some abandon the race. Those that continue have a long way ahead. Usually, about this time, the first athlete of the Spartathlon arrives at Sparta, as the last one is still running over the mountain. It is a difference of about 80 kilometres. Tegia has great history. Built on the road that leads to Laconia, it played an important role in the area's history. The temple of Alaeus Athena on the settlement impresses with its majesty. The Byzantine office of the diocese, the 10th century's imposing church that was built on the city's ancient conservatory. rain falls along the trail in Laconia. A few moments of rest and relaxation at the checkpoint at the monument.
Excellent.
Usually, the rain makes it harder for the volunteers at the checkpoints than for the athletes. Back at Sparta, Leonidas is expecting the runners. Each September, he awaits their greeting. He is not only the king's symbol of Sparta, but also of the Greek ancient world. His decision to defend the pass of Thermopylae with 300 comrades in arms made him and the Spartans immortal. Behind the statue stands the remains of ancient Sparta, with the great theatre perched on the Acropolis. Time passes, and the athletes finish one by one. An olive wreath and some water from Evrotas, the only trophies and reward for finishing. Then the athletes move on to the nearby mobile infirmary of Sparta's hospital for precautionary medical examinations.
How do you feel? Good? Taxi?
In the last 5 years, I've come almost every year to the Spartathlon. I think that's the least tribute we can offer to those athletes that come from all over the world to honour us in that that we do here. We've organised a little infirmary that you see here, and we provide first aid to the athletes that arrive after so many hours of hardship. The hospital nursing staff participate, and we have great assistance from the local municipality.
Συμμετέχει το ιατρικό προσωπικό του νοσοκομείου, το νοσηλευτικό προσωπικό, καθώς και έχουμε μεγάλη βοήθεια και από το Δήμο.
I think that it is great that there are people that overcome their limitations by setting an example that we can achieve anything in life if we want it and if we work hard for it. It is the best example that we can give to our children. They run for an idea. They run for an olive wreath. That is why there are no winners, but only finishers. That means for us that as we become volunteers, we become human beings whoever we help. It is a preparation that we have used, we love and we want to help. The feelings are amazing. It is an ideal. We revive the ancient course of Pheidippides, and mainly through voluntary and international effort. I am very happy that I participate in this race as a volunteer, helping those individuals to accomplish their superhuman effort. It is as if I have participated, as if I also ran with them. For me, after 27 years of continuous presence, Spartathlon means a life. It has become an experience. Spartathlon loves us. If it did not love us because we love it, we wouldn't be together. I have two kids, and this is my third child, if I can put it that way. This is the vacation that every working person waits for, as he works 10.5 months a year. It is in our minds and inside our hearts, and that is what we do every year. We feel for the athletes. We share the joy of those that finish. We feel sorry for those that quit. We try to make their lives easier. We try to steal a little bit of their glory. I've been involved with Spartathlon for 3 years now, so my participation is recent compared to others. But honestly, it is a life experience, because you live the fact that the impossible can become real. And it is very important for me to see that, and especially my partner, who I try to support as much as I can. It's great publicity for our country and its people, because they offer a lot to society. For me, they are the Greek pride. Spartathlon is a part of our culture. Me, as an athlete, it represents me. I have run and finished 2 times, in 91 and 92. I live this race again and again when I see those run. It brings up an emotion, and you want to help as much as you can. Since you cannot run, I, for instance, cannot run, you try to help those who run as much as you can, in order to finish and enjoy what they are doing. Personally, I leave my job since I have my own business and look forward each year to the last week of September to come to the race, because it's something that gives us energy. Personally, it helps me a lot. I came here because I believe that what I do is very important. I volunteer every year. I like this institution a lot. It is a race that really touches me, and I enjoy it very much. I wait for this every year. For me, Spartathlon is some days of relaxation, no matter how paradoxical this may sound. Although there is a lot of physical fatigue, there are days of emotional relaxation. For me, Spartathlon is an excitement, something that I cannot describe. For 10 years, we watch the finishing line and we cry. Half the men faint, and I admire the women that finish.
Not too much.
The satisfaction of victory. A victory of the mind over the body. The extending of human endurance. The triumph of the athletic spirit and of its values. Unique moments that stagger. The ancient world comes from the past to inspire today. The fundamental values of life award human civilization. It is the moment that man is touched by joy and glory.
At
night, Sparta celebrates and honors the athletes of the Spartathlon. The renowned city, the political and spiritual leadership, the people. The first woman to finish is Sumi Inakaki. The Japanese athlete had also finished first among the women in the past and completes the Japanese dominance of the race for 2009, since the Japanese were the largest group of entrants. 69 men and women athletes participated and 30 of them finished. The trail was also completed by Japanese Yoshiko Matsuta and the American Lisa Blitz. The 27th Spartathlon is now history. It was yet another successful race with a great number of entries and a significant number of athletes that made it to the finishing line. But because of the historical background and foreign interests, participation continues to grow, and we will have to revise our requirements for qualification so it becomes more difficult, in order to eliminate the number of athletes in a way that will also raise the standard. This is one of the unique long-distance foot races, and it compares to the Sahara's race.
Με έναν τέτοιο τρόπο που να ανεβάσει και το επίπεδό τους. Είναι γεγονός ότι είναι ένας από τους μοναδικούς σε δυσκολία αγώνες υπερμαραθωνίων αποστάσεων και συγκρίνεται με το μαραθώνιο της Σαχάρας.
Monday in Athens. The association holds a reception for the athletes. Smiles, pleasantries, discussion. The family celebrates together. I won once in 2002. After that, I couldn't make it, although I wanted to very much. I am deeply touched that my dream came true. This year, we had almost 70 entries from Japan, and all of them were lovers of the sport. I ran for them, too. I was carrying their dream, and that is why I ran well. For me, Spartathlon isn't only a race. It is a meeting with friends from all over the world that we meet here every year to talk to each other and to enjoy the race. It doesn't matter who wins. What matters is helping each other so that we all finish. This is the magic of the contest. For me, Spartathlon is a test of life. It demands very tough practice, and as long as I am healthy and strong, I will continue to participate. I am very happy that I finished. This is the third time I've run this race. The reason for that is the great history of the race, Leonidas. All those factors have amazing symbolism. By running this course of 246 kilometers, I have made a lot of friends. People are very friendly, and this is a race that creates friendships. So, two Japanese, two Greeks, and me, we finished all together at the same time.
Si è resa meno difficile e anche più sopportabile, nonostante i suoi 246 chilometri. Posso dire che questa è un'esperienza al di fuori di tutto, ecco, perché unisce molte persone, molti amici. Io posso ringraziare solo quattro compagni di viaggio, due greci e due giapponesi che mi hanno aiutato e anche motivato per far sì di poterla terminare e per avere nuove amicizie.
Spartathlon's president salutes. Present are ambassadors and organizations' representatives. Also present, the Stavros Niarchos Institution that decisively supports the race's organization. Here also are the sponsors. Next year's race date is set for the end of September 2010. 2,500 years since Marathon's historical battle and Pheidippides' historical run.